Hello everybody, welcome to our new video. It's been a long time we haven't made a video so far. It's been a week, but we come back with something relevant. We want to do something important here. So like when I try to go to Kali Linux and try to go to localhost, I put my PHP files in here, but then I find like it tells me like you don't have permissions to access this resource. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna enter. You can see I have my Apache is there, I've got my PHP, I'm sure it's on there, I've got everything is working. But now why is that folder? This is the PHP file, so folder, so I want to run my program. So this is what I see. So what can we do? So what I'm gonna do, you can see this URL, that's where I am, and I tried to give permission to this, but it could not work. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna create a new thing, then I close here. So we see this is the error we have. I got to save this error because it's gonna help me somehow somewhere, and also I have to save it somewhere. Yeah, if I'm gonna save it here first of all, because if you find the error, copy it somewhere. If you fix it, then you can manage to tell people how did you fix that error. So it's gonna save people's time everywhere in the world. So what are we gonna do now? You go to your folder. I'm talking about this folder. I wanna go here. That's where I put my PHP. You click in here. You scroll down, look for var. Then when you're in var, then we click for www, then you click in HTML, then you click on D. So in D, this is where my files are. So, but I wanna test something so easy. I wanna do this. When I'm in HTML here, I want to copy this and paste it here. I want us to test something simple. Then we want to name this wanna say now dot php. Okay, then after I'm gonna rename that and say we really wanna see what's the problem, why it doesn't show up. So after doing this, we're gonna find that we're gonna delete everything here, and also we say php. And we close our PHP tag here, and we say echo. You close that and say I am working. Okay, that's good. After saying I'm working, we want to see that if it works really. But this is a bad, I should make this to be capital I. Say I'm working, then I'm gonna save. You can remember our file is called PHP, code now.php. After saving that file, we're gonna go back and we go to our browser here, and we type in now.php. Then as you can see that our PHP is working properly. And how do you know that? Because that is a text, someone could say no. So now what we're gonna do, we're going to test another file, and then we go to the conclusion that what is the problem there. So I wanna scroll down here, and come here, I go to www. Then we go in here, this is our file. Then we can open it. See, when you open it, then we're gonna say, I wanna assign something, I wanna declare something here. I say num1 num m equals to 1. Then we're gonna assign num 2, num, it's gonna be num 2 u equals to 2. So you close this and say answer. The answer equals to answer equals to there's no reason need for me to put these. I'm sorry guys. No. Okay. Answer equals to num. Okay, plus. We're doing some simple mathematics here in PHP. Then we close that. After closing that, we're gonna say we wanna echo the answer here. So if it works, just know that we don't have a problem with our PHP 100%. So we want to figure that out here. Okay, we're gonna say echo. Okay, echo, is that echo right? No, the echo's wrong. We're gonna say echo. Then we put this here, and then we save. So after saving, make sure you don't have any problems there. The reason why I'm doing this, I want to show you that what we're going to fix, we have to know exactly what's the issue there. Okay, it shows that we have two, but why is it that? Don't you think the calculations are wrong? I believe they are wrong. 1 plus 2, it should be 3. So I wonder why the answer is 2. Okay. Oh yeah, I see. Num plus now. Okay, I see. It should be 3. I did some mistakes here. Made a small mistake. So it should be. Once it's 3, then you go on. You can see that everything is working. So now it simply means we have permission error. Problems here. So once you got that, it works nicely. Once you go to D, then it doesn't work. So it tells you don't have permissions to access this resource, so which is okay. I wouldn't argue with anybody on that. Okay, so remember me saving this. I don't want to be in a situation whereby I'm forgetful. Still, I'm gonna copy this to put it here and still save this. Okay, once we're done with that, since that's the problem, I'm gonna do what? We're gonna try a couple of things. So we wanna get the path. What is the path here? We wanna go on command prompt and we get that. Okay. Our path here is, how do you get the path? You open the folder you want to do and say, you open and say open with in terminal. So once you do that, then you get that. You're gonna copy exactly this and copy that. After copying that, you go to your terminal and start typing in chmod, ch, all small letters, but it got to be sudo chmod mod, then minus capital R space 777, and after that 777, you're giving right execute and read. So you paste into that, delete that, you say okay. Once you say okay, let's see if that worked. Let me go to, I wanna go to something like on a browser, man. Localhost. We're gonna pick up your browser, your favorite browser, and say localhost, then say D, that's the folder. Wow, that worked like a charm, guys. And that's the solution here. We had what they call permission error. So we did not have any access to that. So you got to give your permissions to your folder, to that folder where you want to access. So you can see now I can access my my website here, my system here. Guys, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, and see you in the next video. If you have anything you say or anything you want to ask, please talk to us in the comment box below. Share our content as much as you can. See you in the next video.